The presidential contest found Donald Trump trying to move on again from something he said a day earlier. Hillary Clinton, meanwhile, looked to capitalize on the furor. Correspondent Lisa Desjardins has our report.
Amid talk of campaign resets, Donald Trump changed scenes today, trading his usual large rally for, first, a small roundtable of coal executives and workers in southwestern Virginia, and later, a speech on jobs, especially mining jobs.
The mines will be gone. The mines will be gone if she gets elected.
That was Trump on offense, but he's also on defense over these words from yesterday about Hillary Clinton and gun rights.
If she gets to pick her judges, nothing you can do, folks. Although the Second Amendment people, maybe there is, I don't know.
Trump told Fox News he meant political action, not violence.
Nobody in that room thought anything other than what you just said. There can be no other interpretation. Even reporters have told me, I mean, give me a break. But they're dishonest people. What it is there's a tremendous power behind the Second Amendment. It's a political power. And there are few things so powerful, I have to say, in terms of politics.
Others charged Trump was indeed inciting violence. Even House Speaker Paul Ryan, celebrating his own primary victory last night, suggested the nominee explain.
I heard about this Second Amendment quote. It sounds like just a joke gone bad. I hope he clears it up very quickly. You should never joke about something like that.
Hillary Clinton in Des Moines, Iowa, slammed her opponent.
Words matter, my friends. Yesterday, we witnessed the latest in a long line of casual comments from Donald Trump that cross the line. Every single one of these incidents shows us that Donald Trump simply does not have the temperament to be president and commander-in-chief of the United States.
This as the Clinton campaign unveiled new Republican endorsements today and publicly launched a new official push called Together for America to win over more Republicans and independents. All that as a new Reuters survey shows more Republican voters may be up for grabs. About one-fifth of registered Republicans said they want Trump to drop his presidential bid entirely. It's led to a new line from the Democratic nominee.
I am humbled and moved by the Republicans who are willing to stand up and say that Donald Trump doesn't represent their values.
But she, too, faced criticism over newly released emails from her time as Secretary of State. They show staffers for the Clinton Foundation worked to gain favors and help for donors, with some of her staff at the State Department. Trump blasted his opponent over the issue.
It's called pay for play. And some of these were really, really bad and illegal. If it's true, it's illegal. You're paying and you're getting things.
With 3 months left in the election, the candidates are hitting hard and looking especially to big states. Tomorrow, Trump heads south to Florida. Clinton goes north to Michigan. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Lisa Desjardins.
We'll turn to the debate swirling around Trump and his temperament later in the program.